Hello friends, we shall continue with the advantages of high voltage transmission. Okay, we have discussed about the first case, that is which reduces the volume of the conductor material, then it increases the efficiency of the transmission, and the third advantage is it decreases the percentage of line drop. Okay, let us see this. Line drop is given by I into R. Okay, so what is R? R is equal to rho L by A. Therefore, what you can write is I into rho L by A. Okay, and what is A? A is I by J. Right? Area of cross section is given by it is I by J, where J is the current density. Okay. So substitute that, what we will get is I into rho L into J by I. So this I and this I get cancels. Okay. So finally what we will get is rho L J. Okay. This is the line drop. Usually percentage, we will take the percentage of line drop. When we take the percentage of line drop, then we divide this by the voltage, the transmission line voltage. So finally what we will write is percentage of line drop is equal to J rho L by V into 100. Okay, where J is your current density, right? Rho is a specific resistance of the conductor. L is the length of the conductor. Conductor in the sense transmission line. Okay, and V is the transmission line voltage. As J rho and L are constants, therefore percentage line drop decreases when the transmission line voltage increases. So this is one more advantage. What is the final impact of this? If the line drop decreases, then the receiving end voltage will be almost equal to the sending end voltage. Okay, so this is what is the advantages of high voltage transmission. Don't think that there are only advantages of transmitting the voltage at a very high level. No, it's not like that. There are some disadvantages also, limitations. We'll see that now. Limitations of high voltage transmission. Okay, so as the transmission line voltage increases, what will happen? It may appear that we have to, it is always advisable to use the highest possible voltage for the transmission of electrical power. But what we have discussed is, if we increase the level of the transmission voltage, then the conductor material decreases. The volume of the conductor material decreases. Finally, what is the result of that is, it results in the reduction in the cost of the conductor material, saves the material cost, and transmission voltage, transmission efficiency also increases. But that is not the case. Why? Because when the voltage level increases, it requires insulation requirement also increases. The increased cost of insulating material, insulating the conductors, you need to insulate the conductors against the high voltage. And then the increased cost of transformers, switchgear and other terminal apparatus. If you increase the voltage, the cost of these materials, these equipments, transformers, switchgears and other terminal apparatus also increases. Not only this, corona loss increases. There will be a skin effect. Because of the skin effect, the effective resistance of the conductor increases. Effective resistance in the sense, the current tries to flow near the surface of the conductor. That means the current density in the conductor is not uniform. And because of this, the effective resistance of the conductor increases. If the effective resistance increases, automatically loss will increase. So this is not advisable. Not only that, what will happen is, as the transmission line voltage increases, the insulators required will also increase, and that of course the cost of the transmission increases. Not only that, the supports that is required for the laying of a transmission line and which have the insulators, you need to have a heavy supports for that. So you need heavy supports. Heavy supports means the cost again increases. And if the transmission line voltage length is more than 500 km, then the stability issues also, there will be a stability issues. So these are all the problems. Okay, so there is economical considerations here. Okay, therefore there is a limit to the high transmission voltage which can be economically employed in a particular case. This limit is reached when the saving in the cost of the conductor material due to higher voltage is offset by the increased cost of transmission, transformer, switch gear, etc. Therefore, the choice of proper transmission voltage is essentially a question of economics. By increasing the voltage, the cost that you save while increasing the voltage and the cost that you incur on the transformer, switch gears and insulators, if they are equal, then that is a economic voltage to be employed for the transmission of high voltage. Okay, so you have to keep this in your mind while discussing while employing a very high voltage. Okay, next we'll see what are the components of the distribution. Okay, this is the distribution substation. Okay, and this distribution substation is connected to the distributors. Okay, these are all A, B, B, C, C, D, D, A. These are all the distributors. Okay, and then these are servicemen. Okay, this distribution substation is connected to the distributors via feeders. Okay, these are all the conductors, feeders, distributors, servicemen. These are all the conductors. But what is the difference here is, the feeder don't have any tappings. The consideration here in feeder is a current. Current has to be maintained constant. Whereas in a distributor, you can take a tappings. What is a design criteria here is to, you have to maintain voltage constant. Okay, here in feeder, this is also a copper conductor. You cannot take a tappings here. Distributor is also a conductor, but you can take a tapping here. The design consideration in case of distributor is a voltage to be maintained constant, whereas design constraint consideration for a feeder is the current has to be maintained constant. Okay, and from the distributor you can take the service mains. Okay, they are these are connected to the households or consumers directly. So this is about the feeders, distributors and servicemen that is being employed in your distribution. Okay, so this completes your first part of module 1. In the next video lecture I will take up overhead transmission. Okay, thank you.